Hey everybody, this is Star, and this is some Capture the Flag Turbine. I think I might be changing my opinion on Capture the Flag maps. I used to say I didn't really like them very much, but I'm starting to enjoy them more. One is because this match is really good. It was a ton of fun to play, and I really enjoyed it. And secondly is because I'm not too familiar with these maps, and it's just fun to, you know, play on a map that you haven't played very often, because I'm getting so sick of Dust Bowl, Gold Rush. I'm just so tired of those maps, so it's really good fun to get into something new here and play on this. Playing as a demo man, constant offense to whittle down the defense on their intelligence. Also got my medic with me, who for this video, I'm going to tell you, Mr. Sexy, despite being Mr. Sexy, is actually my girlfriend. And that kind of ties into what I want to talk about for this video, is that whenever all the videos that I've posted, a few where Mr. Sexy is my medic, and a lot of it isn't just, oh, I'm doing good because I have a pocket medic. With here, it's quite a bit different. We've played together for a really long time. And even when we're not communicating, I know what she's going to be doing. Like, kind of have an idea what's going to be going on, what to be expected. So that's a really important thing to have with your medic, is, you know, communication. But then even if you don't need it, that's a big plus. And then the second part is that we are actually usually on Skype the entire time that we're playing, constantly talking, even though we don't actually use the in-game chat. So we are in constant communication of everything that's going on. I call out every Uber. I say when we're going to use it, where we're going to go. So everything is very, very well planned out. And this is our first big push on this point where we're taking out the sentry, and I go for the intelligence. And right as I grab it, I saw those stickies and I was going to back off. And that was a really sneaky spot by Ragnus. One of those things, too, where every time from now on where I ever play this map, I'm always going to look up in those rafters to make sure that same thing doesn't happen again, which ties into the fact that I'm not very used to CTF maps. But back on to the point is that having a medic that you actually can communicate with in that way is such a big deal, where there's so many things that I just want to stress that there's a lot of stuff going on in, like, the sub-game here that you're never going to get to see. You see the gameplay, you see him being healed, but there's, like, a lot more going on behind the scenes that is making what we're doing here a huge success to keep my medic alive and stuff. Usually when I'm playing with other medics that I don't know too well, I'll be, like, turning around to check them all the time to make sure there's nothing going on back there. But with Mr. Sexy, I don't have to do that, because if anything happens, we're on Skype, we're going to say anything that happens, and I'll pretty much hear that, so it's a much more comfortable pocket experience for me as far as that goes. And yeah, we have a lot of experience doing it together, so it really works out well. Put a sticky trap on that wall while that soldier came around. They kind of forced everyone to second guess coming back there. We have our second Uber charge right now, so we're going to go in here and see what we can do, take down one sentry being built, one that was almost destroyed, and I know this guy is up in the rafters now. I saw him, and I knew he was there. I was going to check anyway, but I run out of ammo here and do some very stupid stuff trying to kill this spy. I turn my back on him, and I have no idea why. The next slash would have killed him for sure, and I'm just like, no, I want you to backstab me. I really don't know what I was thinking there, but even if I had killed that spy, I really don't think I would have moved that intelligence very far. So it's another failed push in the grand scheme of things that we weren't able to actually get anything done. But we, to actually get the intelligence, what I do want to say is we did get a lot of things done. We destroyed, you know, those two sentries that were being built. And not only the fact that they need to be rebuilt, is that a lot of engineers really, like, rage quit the engineer class. When they get one sentry that gets blown up, they go into a fit where they're like, ah, I'm so sick of playing engineer now, I'm gonna switch classes. So destroying defense is really good in that way in some servers where engineers quit. And you also saw in that tunnel a moment ago, I destroyed another sentry where he was trying to be very aggressive with it, which was probably him being frustrated that his first one was destroyed, which gave me another chance to destroy it. And up on the left-hand side of my screen, you could vaguely see a teleporter that was placed there. I destroyed it earlier in the match, but it's another one of those things with this map where I'm just not used to it yet, and I should know that it's there. I mean, I even did see it, and there's a heavy shooting at it right now, and I just don't make the connection until I finally see somebody come out of it and take the time to destroy it. We're going to have our Uber very, very shortly here and going to do our third push. Unfortunately, I do want to mention, I did skip one of the captures for this map. I don't remember quite what happened, if I joined later, what was the deal. But yeah, we're only getting the last two captures. Our team had a slight advantage when I joined, and I absolutely pushed these guys into their spawn, hold them there. Had a whole bunch of teammates behind me, so I knew that one of them would be able to capture it. I am a little bit surprised at how long it took them to capture it, but they still did that, which is definitely awesome. I I honestly don't want to waste my time capturing point, because like I said, I'm doing more of an offense thing. Time spent running away is bad, and this is a perfect example of why I don't know this map. There is a duct right above us where people can fall down, and that pyro falls down behind us. I completely forgot that existed, and it really whittles, it just messes us up completely. I don't know why I'm saying whittles again, but what I wanted to do there was, you know, hold that area. If anyone came down the stairs, I was completely confident they wouldn't have been able to get in there. And I wanted to get the intelligence right as our team captured, so I can get the recapture. And shortly after I died, that became available. But didn't know for that. Completely forgot about that air duct. And that is another thing. Whenever I make mistakes like this in my videos, you're like, "Oh, you did that. You're so dumb, Star." But the truth of the matter is that I know I'm dumb, and that is never ever going to happen to me again, because for one, I felt stupid when it happened, and now I'm showing it to you all. It's kind of like ingrained in my mind. Oh, I remember that video I made where I looked like a complete fool because I forgot this huge detail about the map. But well played by the pyro. I saw a big opening there where I was able to get in and take the intelligence, because nobody had really reset up defense, and it was very faulty on their part. I get it a little bit out of there, and that's good enough for anyone on our team to be able to capture it once you get it out of their significant defense. And we win this round. It was a really fun match to play on top score, as you'll see. Yep, there, you saw it. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please press the like button. It helps me out a ton.